So the speaker for today on this brand will be Mr. Bhavesh Vyas, who is a postgraduate in biochemistry from KM Hospital and GS Medical College, Mumbai. Mr. Bhavesh Vyas, with 27 years of experience in pharmaceutical industry, has been associated with Roche, Aventis, MSD, Wockhardt, and Allergan. He has traveled the journey from medical rep to business unit head while picking up the core marketing experience during the launch of Inogla. I hand over the session to you, Bhavesh sir. Please take us through.
Yeah, can you hear me now? Sound check.
Yes.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, my sincere thanks to Vivek sir, with whom I've been associated for over a decade, and I've seen his passion in action in encouraging good marketing practices in our pharmaceutical industry. This World Pharma Brand Managers Day is, of course, one of his attempts. This is one of the major shows, of course, but this is one of his attempts, which he does many such programs throughout the year to encourage young marketeers to adopt ethical marketing practices, science-based marketing practices, and I'm seeing them in action. His books are a wonderful read. So thank you, sir, for including me, and a happy birthday once again to you. Thank you, Dr. Swati. Thank you to all the participants who have patiently heard all the stalwarts, beginning with Dr. Sanjay Mitra, Dr. Sandeep Bhattacharya, and others throughout the day. And I do hope to contribute that how Januvia was built as a mega brand through the excellence in execution. This was a product which was basically a beautiful scientific product where strong marketing principles were applied. It was a breakthrough product, first of its kind. It was a first of its kind DPP-4 inhibitor introduced by MSD. However, it was just not the first of its kind that made it success. There was a blend of marketing, product development, the trials that were conducted, so well designed, and also there was very good marketing insights driven into this. Last but not the least, this was a product which was made by the team. It was just not marketing or medical. It was a blend of these are just some of the names from various functions that made this brand a big success in India. Beginning with Dr. Sandeep Bhattacharya, who was, of course, the brain behind the whole marketing project, and many others. So, like for any brand, there's always a beginning. Well, this was the first-in-class DPP-4 inhibitor to be launched globally and in India. It's for diabetes, of course. The two researchers, they won one of the most prestigious award in the pharma research space, and that is the PHRMA Awards, Discoverers Award. And it was for the first time in the history of these awards that a pair of women were winning this. So you can understand that this product was born special. It still is a special product for MSD. It's over a $5 billion product globally, more than a decade after it's launched. And there have been so many other DPP-4 inhibitors that followed. This was launched in May 2008, less than 2 years of the global launch. It shows that the importance of Indian market to the global company. And this was the fastest 100 crore product in the Indian pharma market. It was in the second full year back in 2010. With this, I would just like to highlight on one fact that there are multiple components of a successful strategy getting into execution, and that is the team, the processes, the communication, the performance matrices. Januvia had all of that, and most importantly, the team had this vision to create the fastest 100 crore brand in IPM. So, what did they do? So, my discussion is going to be not only about strategy, it's going to be a little more on the execution of the strategy, because the core strategy, Dr. Bhattacharya, of course, discussed this in his talk, if you were present in the morning, that Januvia had this challenge that it was perceived as a very strong in its side effect profile. But the existing gold standard at that point of time was glimepiride, which also I've had the privilege of launching when I was an area manager in Aventis. Pankaj sir definitely would remember that, was perceived to be excellent in terms of its efficacy. And let us remember that in diabetes, the patient judges a doctor by his blood reports. The patient would switch the doctor if he does not, if the patient doesn't feel that, you know, he is getting a good treatment and his diabetes is coming under control. So doctors would always give importance to efficacy as against the safety. This was the biggest challenge that Januvia had in front of it. It's not that it was not an efficacious product. It was a highly efficacious product in its measured ability. And therefore, the baseline concept was introduced by MSD. The science of baseline concept was very simple, that the higher the HbA1c at the beginning of the treatment for a patient, the better would be the reduction with Januvia. And they proved it to the medical fraternity through the various advisory boards, because the KOLs of the country were quite skeptical that you were to charge a premium, aren't you? This is a new first of its kind coming from a global stable. So they had to be convinced, and a lot of hard work went behind that. So therefore, it shows the importance of the teamwork of medical and marketing in setting the expectations right of the customer. Going forward, in the pre-launch phase, it was not only important to have the global product coming in and a good scientific team, each person on the field, it was going to be a mega team of 300 reps. I'm talking about 2008. Now, that was a time when to launch a division with over 300 people was a big thing. It was a big risk that the company was taking, and every person to the last man was chun-chun-ke picked up. To say that every person was special, the best in his own territory. And then they were equipped with the best of the trainings. 20 days training extensively, beginning with the A to Z of diabetes management, the complications, everything. The amount of passion that was built in, and that is where I am Januvia was the slogan that was born within the team. The team was so supercharged. Now, when the team came out to the field, they were still a few months away from the launch of the product. So how did the time was utilized? Well, for the first time, a thorough communities of practice mapping was done. Every doctor on a DML of the rep was mapped to whom was he looking up to in terms of trusting for science at his city level, at his state level, at the national level, and at an international level. Now, friends, you would wonder, what did MSD do with this? Well, they utilized this data to the T. Each of the meetings that were done pre-launch, over 300 meetings were done. They were done as per the COP mapping of the doctor. If it was a national level KOL, such doctors were mapped to the global KOLs and their meetings were conducted. If it was a state level, I mean, it was not to define the ranking of the doctor, but friends, we need to understand that what was MSD doing? MSD was setting up the context of the product so strongly that the expectations from the product were set right even before the product was launched. And in this, there was very strong medical support. Each meeting was militaristically monitored, if I can say that in retrospect. But the beauty of this was that the strategy, let us remember the strategy that it had to set in the right expectation, was very well executed through its various tactics. This led to the launch and the ramp up. The team was very charged. The COP meetings, over 300, you imagine every rep was thoroughly involved. He underwent and sat with the specialist for 1 or 2 days to understand his own treatment paradigm. So the rep had thorough knowledge of the top 30 to 50 of his doctors. And when the product came in, there was no looking back for the team. Whether it was a Monday or a Sunday, the team was supercharged to go out and work. Every doctor's prescription flow was monitored to the extent that the last chemist knew the product Januvia. And mind you, This was a 42 rupees a tablet back in 2008. It was 7 times the price of Glimepiride's best brand, that was at 6 rupees, from Aventis. So this shows that how well the execution was done, and thank the managers, the first line managers, the second line managers. They were so meticulous in their planning and monitoring that every reps, every call was ensured to be successful. A couple of months down the line, now why I stress so much on the monitoring, the training, is that there was a surprise element that came in. There were sudden reports of adverse effect coming in with the drug, pancreatitis. This could have been potentially damaging for the brand. But the team was so well trained, so well communicated. Back in 2008, MSD was using WebEx conference tools very regularly. So communicating with the entire team was at a beck and call away. The medical and the marketing got together, responded with the global support, and within 24 hours, every rep was knocking on his top 30 doctors with the Rebitil and giving the correct perspective as to what was the problem that was being reported. MSD was very transparent in its communication to the team and to the doctors. Therefore, this crisis, potentially damaging crisis, was overcome very successfully. Followed by this, there were large multi-speaker meetings which were rolled out. Now, multi-speaker meetings are always a big challenge to do because you have to balance the speakers' egos, you have to balance the speakers' availabilities, and you have to balance the availability of your attendees. Now, managing such complex tasks, the teams successfully conducted nothing less than 40 to 50 Incretin summits all India. To give you my own case example, we were doing the first one on 30th of November 2008 in Calcutta. Now, if you remember 2008, 26/11 happened. Ajmal Kasab and his gang had attacked Bombay. One of the star speakers was supposed to come from Bombay. Now, he dropped out at the last minute. He was not in a position to travel. What do we do? Well, we had to approach one of the KOLs within the city. And unfortunately, he was not a part of the panel and he was to be brought in as a last minute speaker. Now, you can imagine the stress. The area manager and the representative, they had that confidence. They went ahead and spoke to the speaker that, "Doctor, we are in the soup. We need your help." Now, how can that happen if that equity has not been built in such a short time? And that is where that program became a grand success. So when you are promoting the right science, you develop the right equity and the right respect along with your KOLs and all your customers. So by then, this product was about a little over a year old. It had scored about 17 crores in the first 9 months. And in the second year, like, I would just like to again remind you of the strategy that the perception had to be corrected. And therefore, a huge blitzkrieg was launched. Every area manager, regional manager, zonal manager, the entire HO team got onto a war footing, dissemination of knowledge on hypoglycemia. Because hypoglycemia was a silent killer. Pankaj sir mentioned extensively in his previous talk, diabetes principles remain the same. And here also, it was the silent hypos which were highlighted very well. And the paradigm shift of changing the success of patients' treatment from fasting and postprandial blood sugar to the monitoring of HbA1c was brought about. Huge number of patients were tested by the teams to show to the doctor the treatment gaps. It was not an easy task because there were intricacies involved in carrying out point of care tests. But the teams were so well trained, right from the area manager to the highest level, to the rep, that every camp had a huge success rate. This, friends, then led to the acceptance and traveling of the journey of Januvia in its perception that it was an efficacious drug which would not give hypoglycemia. This was backed by two excellent initiatives in terms of patient care. Dr. Bhattacharya mentioned that you provide a value add to the patients. Sparsh. Now, this was for the first time probably in India, a full-fledged counseling program. Not to discount the other counseling programs that were being run, this was a program which would go on for months together without any incentive to the patient in terms of freebies or goodies or samples. This was a pure education and counseling program. Dr. Bhattacharya in this slide showed the Philippines data. There was Indian data similarly in Sparsh because Sparsh had originated from India and then later on it was shown, taken over to Philippines and many other countries. Now, this was a program which would counsel the patient in his vernacular language, would talk about diet modification with his own diet preferences. Like if I'm a Gujarati staying in Bangalore and I prefer a mix of Gujarati and South Indian diet, I would be helped out planning a diet accordingly. It was not a prescriptive diet. It was a diet which I would own it. And therefore, the success of therapy would be there. Along with this, a wonderful program along in tying up with Public Health Foundation of India and Dr. Mohan's Academy, which program then even got a recognition from the WHO, was the CCEBDM. This was a pure certificate educational initiative of MSD, which was talking to doctors, taking the doctors through the complete management of diabetes. This was one of its kind because all the other courses in the past, they had focused on the therapy area's interest of the company. But here was a course, CCEBDM, along with PHFI, a neutral body, taking the doctors through the complete evidence-based management of diabetes. This, friends, built in significant scientific respect for the company. Now, this is what I'm sharing this because many of you are not going to be only brand managers of your life, right? You're going to become CEOs. You're going to start up your own companies. So you need to understand the value that your brand delivers can be in multiple ways, including your brand as a company. And these kind of ventures help you build up the brand value of your own company and your product as such. So what is the outcome? I am going to stop at about this outcome. Within 2.5 years, this product for a period of Jan to August clocked 100 crores. Within 28 months, it had hit this mark. And this was not, I'm not talking about the cumulative number. This was the number for the individual year. That was the amount of success that Januvia Janumet. In between, of course, I missed out that Janumet was launched somewhere in the middle of 2009, achieved. It still remains, I think, a record that the fastest 100 crore. And as of today, the Sitagliptin franchisee, which is owned completely by MSD, is more than a 1500 crore. So friends, when you're looking at strategy, you have one strategy and many elements of its tactics. It is the implementation of these tactical elements through the team, the processes that you build in, the communication that you have, and the performance matrices that you can drive your success. So therefore, my appeal to all the brand managers, promote the right science. Don't leave science. We are in an industry where we are dealing with a person who is scientific and we are dealing with human life. Do your groundwork well. Identify your right strategic levers and don't change them. Stick to the strategy. Do your customer mapping, segmentation targeting, attribute mapping very well so that your communication is very sharp and unique. And do not forget your tactics have to be tied to your strategic levers. The minute there is a disconnect between your strategic lever and your tactic, your success will become transactional. Have the right team in place. Find the right motivational levers for your team. prepare a detailed execution plan. I think the brand managers stop thinking once their brand presentation is over. No, your brand presentation acceptance should be your starting point. Because if your execution plan is not in detail, you will not be able to monitor them well. And unless you monitor them well, you will not be able to define your course corrections, whatever required also. And last but not the least, anticipate exigencies and be a solution provider to your field force. That's all. Namaste from my end. Would be free to take questions. You can reach out to me on my personal contact details also. Thank you so much, Vivek, sir. Thank you, Swati. And thank you all the participants for bearing throughout the day. And I am sure it was worth it because I have gained quite a bit today. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bhavesh Vyas, sir. You told about promoting the right science, emphasis on training, implementation, and educational campaigns. And you already summarized the session with the last slide. I think this marathon learning sessions from the speakers has been very well summarized by you.